concern coming in, not about the fact that we shooting the ball, because we think we're a good shooting team, and but we want them on our terms. We felt like in New York we had some looks that we normally make, but then we also felt like we pressed on a few of them. Thought the same thing today. I thought we turned down a couple that we know we want guys to take, but yet I think we took three or four that we thought we pressed on. And that's where we've got to get that balance. And but coming off, we came back, we've had two really hard, tough physically and mental practices because we felt like we needed it to get our back where we think we need to be to continue to get better for what we're going to get into here, you know, going forward. And I thought the way our guys came out and responded today was really good, because we were concerned as a coach and staff because of how much energy we spent the last 2 days in practice. And for them to come out and respond the way they did defensively was really something that, you know, as a staff, we're proud of them.
Coach, piggybacking on that, your fluid defense, the last 2 years, I mean, I know last time was a loss, but the last 2 games, you guys have really locked down defense. What's going on that at the court?
Well, and the thing, Rob, is that we think we can get better, and we really do. We think we can become a and we've added some things to our defense, too, that we'll continue to add that to give us more of a package if we need it at certain times. But the fact is that we've got a group of guys that understand. They're taking pride in the fact they want to be a really good defensive team. We know to do that, we're going to have to be a good offensive team, because if you're not good on offense, it really puts a lot of pressure on your defense. If you turn the ball over a lot, the fact we didn't turn it over very much today, and it allows us to get our defense set. But the biggest thing is the mindset going in. These guys have done a good job of preparation. Greensboro is a really good basketball team. We thought of our bye games coming in that we knew these guys would play us tough and hard. Mike Jones, I recruited Mike when he was at Paint Branch High School while I was an assistant at George Mason years ago, and he was on the staff at Georgia with Kenny Mack and Dennis Felton, two of my former assistants, and Kenny's with us here, obviously. But Mike is a terrific coach and took over a program that their DNA is winning, and for us to play come out and I think we gave them the ultimate respect in the fact that we came out and played as hard as we could play against them, which I think is – and again, we had great respect for them coming in, but for our guys to do what we did, and knowing that, Rob, that we do have to get better defensively in some areas, but and we need more everybody to understand what we're doing especially when we change our defenses.
Rick, are you surprised with as much roster turnover as there was that they've been this locked in defensively, this group?
No, I don't think so, because you know what, we've always tried to, you know, we always talk about how defense will play every night. If you're good defensively, you've got a chance every single night if you play it, and if you give yourself a chance on the offensive end. We didn't do that so much with Tech. You know, we didn't do it so much against Villanova. The two losses we had, we let our offense it hurt us. But two teams that defend extremely well themselves. But to answer that question, no, I don't think so, because I think our guys understand if they're going to play, they're going to have to do that. Most of our substitutions are based on what guys are getting done on the defensive end, and what they're not getting done based on, are they locked into our scouting report? Are they bringing the energy and the fight that we need them to bring? And then certainly on the offensive end, if guys are playing in the flow, but most of those subs, and we're trying to convince them, and I think they've done a good job for the most part. They get tired, they check out, and hand it off to somebody else, and that person's got to go in and be ready to play and take it back to a different level.
Mike.
And Ben.
Yeah, Rick, you mentioned those practices the past couple of days. What went into making them so intense, and why was that something you guys really wanted to do in those couple of days?
Well, we spent a lot of time working against a really, really hard physical defense, because that's what's bothered us in two games, teams packing it back in there, as we knew we're going to get a chance to shoot as many threes as we wanted to today. We knew that coming in. And so we worked against, you know, how to try to control the belly of the floor, and both offensively and defensively. But physical, knowing that you're going to have to fight when you drive. You're going to have to be physical with your body against traffic where there's teams in there trying to deflect. But yet, we didn't do that so much in two losses, and so we did a lot of that, which also helped us with our defense because we keep talking about us being better defensively, making plays away from the ball and deflecting. But where we've got to get better is when we do turn people over, we've got to get out and go as opposed to just think we're going to settle into running our traditional break. We need to get out and go with it. And we have numbers. We need to try to create numbers and try to take advantage of it.
Ben and Troy?
It seems like you feel like you all learned from the loss to Texas Tech with the performance tonight. Is the next step making sure you kind of start to do it consistently and show up on Tuesday night and give them the same effort, the same energy?
You know, I would tell you this. I don't think there's been a night really, maybe one game, where we haven't given it the effort. Where guys have been pretty much like on the defensive end. I think that we're still a work in progress on the offensive end. But I think we get a little bit impatient at times because the style we play, we got a lot of movement. We've got a lot of different things that we're tried to build to play a lot of different styles depending on what the game folds into. But with that said, I'll be disappointed. I think our coaching staff, I think our players will be disappointed if we don't continue to move forward because we've got to get better. There's no doubt consistency, reliability, being resilient when you aren't shooting well, all those type things. I told our team the other night the Tech game was a tough, hard-fought game, and nothing to take anything away from Texas Tech. But as poorly as we played and still to have a chance to win it speaks volumes in some ways. But the fact is we've got to keep going. So we'll be disappointed if we don't lock in and get ready for the next opponent that we play.
Rick, top 20 in the nation turnover margin, right, climbing up that list after today. Just how important is it for this team for y'all to get where y'all want to be by the end of the year to continue taking care of the basketball, also taking it away?
Well, it's important. Obviously, again, your offense can help your defense so much if you're efficient on the offensive end. And there's been games when we've been very efficient. There's been some, and again, we're still at times a little bit too impatient. We had some looks early, and there's going to be nights, but you got to give them credit too because we want to be a big time offensive rebounding team. But when you play against people and they start scouting you, they say this guy goes, you got to keep him off the block. Then it gets down to, will you counter that block out? Will you try to get around the guy as opposed to laying on his back? I don't think we're there yet with that. We've got a couple guys, and do we have anybody that consistently does it? I don't know if we have anybody on the scout report right now that they say you must keep this guy off the glass. We've got to get that from more than one guy, and on the other end, we got to rebound. We got to block out. We spent a lot of time doing that the last 2 days. That's where it got physical, and got heated at times because it was body on body. But again, to be the team we want to be, we've got to be good in a lot of areas. And obviously, taking care of the ball is a big part of it. But it goes back to consistency and who can we count on every time. And I thought tonight everybody went in the game, took the minutes serious, and tried to do what we wanted them to do.
Rick, how nice was it to see Josiah have some shots go down just after the way that his season had gone so far?
Well, again, I've told people we're around these guys so much, and we talk about body language with them, and we know their body language. And Josiah is, I'm telling you, he's a big-time shooter. He is. And I'm sure teams look at his numbers and say that. And so I told him, I said, you don't need to force anything because you're going to get all the looks you want. Just do it on your terms with the rhythm. I thought he really got in rhythm today with his shots. And I hope people don't guard him because he's one guy, I'm telling you, when he's open, he's going to shoot it. And that, to me, is another growth in his development because he's always been a very pass-first kind of player. And the fact is, when he's in rhythm and shooting it, He can shoot it as well as anybody.
Coach, a guy was plus 26 coming off the bench tonight. Just kind of speak to his
I didn't hear what you said. Who's the name?
Zakai.
Well, Z's become a major part of our program and his team. And again, it just goes to show you the game gives you what you put into it, because he's a player that gives it everything he's got every day. He's up there last 2 days. He's been the last guy. He and Josiah both have been up there late shooting the ball. And Zakai's working on trying to get better. And each guy up there, I mean, you stick around at practice, certain guys are going to put the time in above and beyond. And like I said, Josiah has done that as much as any player since we've been here, since I've been coaching. I mean, he takes his game serious. And Zakai, for coming in a week late and understanding the offense like he does, and he brings that energy. You know, he really does. I think VJ can do that too. I mean, VJ is a guy that when he locks in on defense, he can create a lot of havoc on other people. And so being able to go to the bench to get that with those guys coming in, because they can oftentimes change the tempo of the game quickly and in a very positive way. But we've got confidence in our bench. You know, I don't know if our guys have thought a lot about starting. You can ask them that. You know, we're going to do what we think's right, but we take a lot of pride in our bench. We take a lot of pride in who's going to finish games, but this team is an unselfish team. They want to win. You watch them today. They all want to play every minute, absolutely, but I think they've got great respect for their teammates, and they're happy when they're out there playing well.
Finish up with Grant. How big have the last couple of days been for Brandon, and how big is tonight trying to move forward with his progress?
Well, we've told him and Olivier, other than we got to have somebody other than John Fulkerson giving us an inside presence. And we got those two guys, Olivier and Brandon, have a chance to give us the physicality that we need. They're both extremely strong players. Brandon doesn't even understand how strong he is yet. And but we need those two guys understanding this team needs that from them. And like anybody, if they're open, yeah, I'll let them shoot it if they're doing the other things. But if they're not doing the other things and shooting threes, probably not so much, because we need those guys to give us what they're capable of. And so Brandon, again, he's had a different mindset the last 2 days in practice. And if he'll continue to do that, he'll continue to play more minutes.
Thank you, Coach.
All right, thank you, guys. Sir.